you we have our being. So, Father, we thank you for the privilege of standing before your people to bring forth your word. Thank you for the people that are in here, God, that you have given them privilege. Giving them a privilege to be in the house of the Lord.
Yes.
Woke us up this morning. Yes. Praise the Lord. Yes. Gave us a mind.
Yes, Lord.
Thank you.
Gave us a mind to come to the house of the Lord.
Yes, Lord.
So, Father, we thank you now.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for your word, oh God.
Yes, sir.
Anoint me, Lord. Father God, to cause your word to go forth in understanding.
Yes, Lord.
Open the minds and the hearts of the hearers to hear what the Lord is saying.
Yes.
In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. I want to talk for a few minutes on you can win with a losing hand.
All right now.
Do you hear what I'm saying up here? You can win with a losing hand. Has any of you guys ever, you know, played cards or what have you? Of some kind. You know, sometimes the hand that be dealt to you, you look, open it up, and you see what's in it, and you can tell. This hand right here is a losing hand.
All right, y'all.
I ain't gonna be able to do nothing with this hand right here. And even sometimes in life here with us, have you ever thought about your life and think that, hey, I was dealt a losing hand here?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this family that I was brought up in, I was dealt a losing hand here, this situation. I'm sorry.
Tell the truth up in him.
But I'm going to share with you this morning that you can win, baby, with a losing hand.
Come on with it.
Hallelujah. In this world of crisis and chaos that we are living in, you know what's going on in this world. I mean, and everything that seems like that can go wrong is going wrong.
It is.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah.
If you live long, I mean, it's gonna get worse.
Mm-hmm. Yes, it is.
But have you ever thought about the chaos that's even going on in the politics and different stuff and greed? Would you ever think in your mind that people, human beings, would bomb rush the White House?
Wow.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Come on now, never.
We saw that on TV in other countries.
Yes, that's right.
You know, but we never would have thought that in our country that it would happen.
Yes.
I mean, so we are living in a crisis, in a world of crisis and chaos. But even though we are living in this world and in this crisis, we can still live and walk in peace.
That's right.
Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? We can still live and walk in peace. Because let me tell you, babies, if you ever been without peace,
oh my God,
and you get some peace in your life, it's priceless.
Sure
will, Pastor. Do you hear what I'm saying up here?
Yes, yes.
If you ever been through something,
come on with it.
Good
come
God, from time.
Come on now.
And then you get some peace from that situation.
Okay.
Oh my God, that peace is priceless.
Yes,
yes, Lord.
Oh my God, thank God.
See, now we can live in this crisis and this chaos in peace because we have a champion who knows how to guide our every move.
Come on with it.
Hey, good God from Zion.
Come on now.
We have a champion.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
We got a champion.
You do you hear what I'm saying?
That's right.
Who, in fact, this champion has already made the final move on the adversary.
Okay.
On the opponent.
Come on,
the devil.
Come on.
Do you hear what I'm saying right here?
Right now.
Come on, preach now.
And he has secured our victory forever.
Oh my God.
Ah, don't you know what I'm talking about?
My God.
There's a victory in Jesus. Our champion. Do you hear what I'm saying? Defeated death, hell, and the grave. Went to the cross. Do you hear what I'm saying? And died for us. Purchased us back off the chopping block of the enemy. Made us acceptable unto God.
That's right. That's right.
Made us and put us in right standing with Almighty God.
Yes.
He paid the debt, the sin debt. He satisfied the courts of heaven.
Come on, yes it did.
Oh, God. Thank
yes,
you.
The Lord.
Hallelujah. Now, John 16 and 33, in the Amplified Bible, here's what it says. You know, when Jesus was getting ready to go back, he was talking to his disciples and telling them, he said, now look, in this world, you're going to have some tribulation.
Uh-huh.
You got that in your head? John 16:33 says, in this world that we're living in, you're going to have some trials and some tribulation.
Yes.
Amen. So don't think it's strange when you're going through something. Amen?
Amen.
Why is this happening to me?
Yeah.
He said, in this world, you're going to have some trials and tribulation,
yes, sir.
Distress. You're going to have some frustration.
Mm-hmm.
But then he said, be of what? Good cheer.
That's right.
Come on now.
He said, be of good cheer. In other words, take courage. Be confident.
All right now.
Certain. Undaunted. This is what he said. All that come out of be of good cheer.
All right now. Be of good cheer.
He said, for I have overcame the world. And then here's a part that I like right here in the Amplified Bible. It says, because I have deprived the world of its power to harm you and have conquered it for you.
All right.
Do you hear what I'm saying? He has deprived the world of the power to harm you and have conquered it for you. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? Hallelujah. You can win with a losing hand. Mm-hmm. Now let's look at an episode in Moses' life.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Where it looked like that he had been dealt a losing hand. So all of you, I think you have read the story or heard the story about Moses, how God called him around 80 years old to lead about 1 million people out of Egypt.
Uh-huh.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Okay, now, when Moses encountered God at the burning bush, okay, God told Moses, this is what I want you to do. Moses said, I can't do this.
Mm-hmm.
He said, I can't even talk. Mm-hmm. You know, I can't even talk straight. You know, I can't do this. So God said, okay, I'm going to send your brother Aaron with you. He can talk
for you.
But do you, if you read the story, do you remember whenever God told, when he went there to get them plagues out? Aaron didn't have to even talk to him. He was talking. Because the anointing makes the difference. Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Because this is what God called me to preach.
I know it.
I said, ain't happened, Captain. Look, I said, come. And he kept dealing with me. I said, all right.
Okay.
Here's what we're going to do. If you give me some confidence,
Yes.
I do. So he worked with me.
Yes.
He worked me. Put the anointing on me. Amen. To get up and speak and talk. You see what I'm saying? The anointing makes the difference.
Yes.
Okay, so now, here's Moses. He's done got up the dirt, and you know, it looks like he's been dealt a bad hand, because whenever he goes to the Israelites to tell them what God says, they don't want to believe him.
Yes.
They're giving him a hard time, frustrating him. And then, you know, on top of that, Moses said, God, whenever they ask me, who shall I tell them send me? To do this thing. God said, you tell them, I am has sent you. I am that I am. Do you hear what I'm saying up in here?
Yes,
God is telling us this morning, I am. Whatever you're going through, I am. Whatever you need, I am.
Yes.
You need healing, I am.
Yes.
You need finances, I am.
Yes.
Good God, from Zion. So, okay, now, then he goes on up in there. He had to deal with that. Had to deal with them Israelites. And if you read the whole story, you know he had to deal with them all through the journey.
Yeah.
But now he had to deal with them while they were still over in Goshen, in Egypt. So then he had to turn around. God tells him to go talk to Pharaoh,
yeah.
The king.
The king.
I mean, you know, go stand up in front of him, Pharaoh, that got a command of everything. God, he went on. Pharaoh ain't hearing him. Okay? So now you know that's frustrating. That's frustrating. Okay? He goes back. He put about 10 plagues on him.
Yeah.
he had to put about 10 plagues on him before they finally
gave in.
That's right.
So now, Moses, do you know how frustrating that is?
Yes, Lord.
Can you picture your own self having to do stuff that you've been through and having to get this straightened out? And that's, it looked like ain't nobody trying to budge, ain't nobody trying to help you, ain't nobody trying to move to do nothing. Frustrating. So Moses thinking, this is a bad hand here. You ever hear some folks say, boy, if I had your hand, I'd throw mine in. But this is a bad hand, man. See, man, he's done got a bad hand here. But God, let me tell you about your bad hand. God is still moving.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Whatever you're going through,
he's
still moving.
Mm-hmm.
See, you might not can see it.
Yes.
See, it don't look like nothing is moving. You've been praying about it. You've been speaking the word over it, but it don't seem like it's moving. You can't see anything. But see, I come to tell you this morning, something is happening in the spiritual realm.
All right, now thank you, Lord.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Thank you, Lord.
See, we look so instantaneous right here.
Yes, yes.
Like you said, so and so and so.
Okay, now.
And he has given us power over all the power of the enemy.
Yes, right.
And then you go walk up in there, and you know somebody's afflicted with a demon, and you say in the name of Jesus, come out.
Okay.
Just because you don't see nothing happening,
don't mean.
See, just like Pharaoh, sometimes he's an epitome of the devil.
Yeah.
Pharaoh didn't give in right then.
Mm-hmm. Right.
So you had to keep right on binding that. Enemy.
Okay.
Do you hear what I'm saying up in here?
Yes,
you got to keep on binding that demonic spirit, that stronghold that's got your loved ones going on.
Yes.
Acting like stupid.
Yes.
Like they stuck on stupid.
Yes. Yes.
But whenever you bind them in the name of Jesus, it's got that. It's happening.
Yes.
But see, you think about okay, you kind of stuck here. You're like Pharaoh. You don't want to give up. You know, but I'm going to keep putting that Jesus on you.
Amen.
Keep putting that blood on you.
Amen.
I'm going to keep.
Amen. Go ahead, O'Hara.
Hallelujah. He's going to move. It's going to move.
Yes.
And it is moving, but you can't see.
Okay.
Let me tell you, you can't see what's happening in the spiritual realm.
Yes.
See, that's one thing that, that's are happening. Things are moving in that spiritual realm.
Yes.
Hallelujah. See, you got to learn how God moves and how the spiritual realm works. Do you see? See, God speaks to you in a still, small voice.
Okay, now.
You see, you got a lot of clamor and stuff going on in your life and stuff. You can't hear. God is speaking.
Yeah.
But you can't hear him if you got a hope. He said, be still and know that I am God.
That's
you got to get somewhere and be still. You got to take time out for God. Oh, go steal away. You ever hear that song, steal away? You got to steal away somewhere. And get quiet.
Yes. Amen.
So you can hear the still small voice. Yes, 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 yes.
Yes, Lord.
And see, we sitting up there looking at Marin. What's that, Jerry Springer? All that chaos that's going on with them.
I hate them.
How you gonna hear God?
That's right.
You need to take some time out to hear God. Oh, that brings, I know what I'm talking about. Say what I'm talking about. So now we're talking about Exodus chapter 14.
Okay.
Now that's where I'm just paraphrasing everything, okay? Mm-hmm. You when you get home, you read Exodus. Okay, so now Pharaoh don't want to turn him a loser. Next thing you know, the 10th plague had to come. That wore him out right there, Pharaoh, out of Egypt.
No, he couldn't take that.
He couldn't take that one right there. That was a blow.
Yeah, that was a blow.
God said that the firstborn.
The firstborn.
The death angel's going to come through.
Mm-hmm.
And so he told the children, the Israelites, you put the blood over your doorposts.
Uh-huh.
Right, see, the death angel is coming through tonight.
Uh-huh. Uh-huh.
And when he see the blood, what's he going to do?
That's
he going to pass over you.
Go ahead now.
So that's why I'm telling you, you got to know that there's power in the blood. There's power in the blood of Jesus. So you hear what I'm saying? So you have to learn how to speak the power of the blood of Jesus.
Blood of Jesus.
Over your people, over your household, over your family. Speak the blood of Jesus. That's power in the blood. Hallelujah. Power. So, okay, they said, okay, go ahead on. Go. Just get your stuff. Dog, cat, get out of Egypt. That's what Pharaoh told them.
Mm-hmm. Just go.
Just get them out here. Go. So while they were burning their folk, the children, the Israelites followed Moses. And they went on out, right?
Mm-hmm.
They trapping on out. And by the way, want a figure one in the bunch.
Not a figure.
Want nobody on crutches.
Mm-mm.
I don't care. Cecil D. Mills, when you saw that, you know that. What was that? They went through that. Somebody was limping. You saw that movie. Oh, everybody was healed.
Yes,
want nobody on crutches.
Right.
Plus, they had finances in their pocket.
Right.
You know why? Do you remember whenever they went? There spoiled the Egyptians. Went and told them, said, look, I want to borrow $100. I'm just paraphrasing. I want to borrow all your jewelry. I want to borrow all your lint, fine linen. They gave it to them.
Uh-huh.
So when those people went out, they had money. They were rich.
Yeah.
They weren't sick.
Mm-hmm.
And so now, okay, Moses is leading them on. They going on. So now God said, take them by this way, Moses, right here. Take them by that way. I'm paraphrasing, okay? You read it for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
He said, take them by this way.
Mm-hmm.
And so they went this way, right beside the Red Sea.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
So, and there was something else over there, so they were like blocked in. So Pharaoh said, okay, I know where they camped at. Evidently, they done blocked themselves in, mm-hmm. so they don't know which way to go now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so now, hell rose up in him again.
Yeah.
So he said, suit up, men. Why did we let them go the first? That's our economy. Because they were they slaves, you know, they were working for it. They built up Egypt.
Okay.
So why did we let them go? I must have been out of my mind. Pharaoh said, I'm paraphrasing, I got it. Let's go get them. Okay, he got up the militia. He got up every commander he had in the armies and all his big chariots.
Yeah.
They took out after the Israelites. So while they were camping around where they were, somebody looked up and saw them coming.
Yeah.
Oh, my gracious. They got frightened. What we gonna do? Lord, this way. Moses, they start complaining to Moses. You brought us out here to die.
Yeah.
But then the Bible says the angel of the Lord got between the Israelites and Pharaoh's army. He had it, made it dark on Pharaoh's side. On the Israelite side, it was light.
Right.
So now, while it was dark, they couldn't see where they were going. So they had to rest. And so then the Bible says that when God spoke to Moses, he said, the children, they're getting all riled up. Oh, what are we going to do? Moses turned around and said, stand still. You're going to see the salvation of the Lord. Holy Ghost rose up in here and said, hey, quit your mumbling and grumbling. You're going to see the hand of God.
Hand of God.
So then God told Moses, said, take that rod in your hand and stretch it out over that Red Sea.
Yes.
Because, see, you know what I'm saying? They was like, yeah, hear that thing, between a rock and a hard place.
A rock and a hard place.
Pharaoh on that side,
yep,
going to kill him. The Red Sea on this side, going to kill him.
Yep.
So, but God.
But God.
Ah, but God. Lord have mercy. When you they were there a what? A losing hand.
But God.
Let me tell you this right here. So then God told Moses, said, stretch out your rod over that Red Sea.
Okay.
The Bible says a strong east wind.
Okay.
Wow.
Strong east wind began to blow. And it blew that water. And it's all night long. It made a path through it. It rained that water from this side. Rained that water from that side. God, won't he do it? Glory to God. He'll make a way for you where it seems to be nowhere. That's our God. That's our champion. Okay, so now, as that wind blew,
okay,
it raised that water from that side.
Okay,
it raised the water from this side.
Yes.
Okay, he's making a path. He's making a path through the Red Sea.
Yeah.
The Bible said that it was so dry, they walked on dry ground. Didn't even get their shoes mud. Do you hear what I'm saying? Won't God, he'll bring you out of that situation.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't care what hand you've been dealt with, if you got God on your side. You can't lose.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So they went on out. They went out on dry ground.
Yeah.
And so then when the angel moved, let the light come so that Pharaoh could see. Okay, he looked over there and saw them going through that. Pharaoh said, let's go get them.
Right.
Let's go get them. Thought they could go through that too. Let me tell you.
Not so.
Baby. So they started out in their chariots.
Okay,
and what did God do? The Bible said he broke the tires off the rims of wheels off the chariot.
Yeah.
They started losing the tires and they got confused
what?
In that. And they saw that the hand of God, they said, we're going to turn around and go back. But they couldn't turn around because when they got in there, that water that was standing up on the side,
okay,
it started coming down.
Oh, yeah.
Oh my God.
Coming
too late now.
Too late.
Yes.
Drowned everyone.
Yes.
Do you hear what I'm saying up in here?
Yes.
You got God on your side.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. I don't care if you got a losing hand.
Yes.
I don't care, but you can win with a losing hand if God be for you.
Yes.
Let me tell you what Psalms 118:5-6 says.
Yes, sir, Lord.
David said, in my distress, I prayed to the Lord, and the Lord answered me.
Yes.
And set me free. Set me in a large place. Delivered me.
Come on now.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yes.
That's what David said. And then he said, the Lord is for me.
Yes.
So you got to know that the Lord is for you. Mm-hmm. He said, the Lord is for me, so I will have no fear. What can mere people do to me?
Mere people.
Mere people. What can they do? A companion scripture to that is Romans 8, 31b, 32. Say, if God be for us, who can be against us? Do you hear what I'm saying up in here? He said, if God be for us.
God be for us.
God.
Come on
the
now.
Supreme being. Master builder, architect, and designer of everything. If that God be for us, who can be against us? Mm-hmm. Whatever you're going through right now, who can be against you? You stand on that word. Be salt, sight, salt and light.
Salt and light.
Be salt and light. Yes. Stand on that word. Plead the blood of Jesus over them. Speak to that stronghold.
Amen.
And command to loose them. Loose her in the name of Jesus. I bind you, devil. So you got to know that you got authority. The word of God tells us we have authority.
Yes, so. Yes we do. Yes,
and so now, and then I like this other one that says, if he that spared not his
you
own son.
You want to go ahead and say that. Come on now.
He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him freely give us all things?
Man.
Do you hear what I'm saying?
Yeah. Glory to God.
Freely. He's going to freely give you all things.
Freely.
Freely.
So, but you got to get in this word and find out how to get it.
Yes.
And what it is and how to get it.
Yes.
Because he's not going to just throw stuff on you.
No.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? He ain't going to fall out the heaven like that.
Right, right.
You know. You got to get in the word and find out. Because he done gave us exceeding great and precious what? Promises. Our promised land. Get in there and get your promise for whatever you're going through.
Amen.
If you get to stand on it, believe God. Mm-hmm. He said, without what?
Faith. Faith is impossible.
And without faith, it's impossible to please me, he said.
Yes, sir.
Because so he that cometh to me must believe that what?
He is.
That he is.
Mm-hmm.
He is. And he is a rewarder to them that what?
Diligently
seek him. Half hearted something don't get you, baby.
That's right.
Diligent. Do you know what the word diligently means?
Oh,
and then he says in Psalms 145 and 18. Get ready to wind it up. The Lord is nigh. That means near. The Lord is nigh unto all them that call upon him. To all that call upon him in truth. Means sincere.
Sincere.
Call upon him in sincerity. Because the Bible says that his eyes are over the righteous. And his ear is open to their cry. You're a child of God. So you got to stand on this word. You got to believe that God is and that he is a rewarder to them that diligently seek him. Of whatever he tells you in that word to do, you need to find yourself doing it. Obedience is what?
Better than
sacrifice. If God be for us, who can be against us?
That's right.
Yeah. I mean, you having a problem with something, you got to talk to God about it.
Amen.
God, I'm having a problem with this right here.
Yes.
And I know you said in your word that I need to do thus and so. But you got to help me. I'm having a problem with it. You got to help me. And then you start out and try to do something about it.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Amen.
I got to, and I'm not trying to throw off on nobody. Don't take it to throw off, but it just popped in my mind because I use this as an example. You believe in God to quit smoking. Do you think he's going to just Every time you light up one, he's going to thump it out your hand. I'm just using that as an example. You know what I'm saying? No, you got to make put forth an effort.
You do.
You got to put forth an effort yourself, too.
Mm-hmm.
Show him in sincerity that you want this thing. Good God, I'm sorry. I know this is a good word right
yes,
here.
Yes, it is.
Lord have mercy. You can win. You can win. You can win with a what?
Losing hand.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Father, in the precious name of Jesus, we just give you praise and glory right now. Thank you for loving us so much. Thank you for encouraging our hearts on this day, God. Thank you, Lord God, that you are our champion. Thank you for Jesus. Hallelujah.